Hey everyone, Sean, Sav, and Moo, and today we're gonna, I have this so often on my teacher's deck, new students that come in with this beautiful interlocking grip. And as you can see right next to us, if you're not doing it correctly, there's you just no way to properly put your fingers on the club. And if the contact with your golf club is off, I'm sorry, but your swing is going to be suffering badly. So you really need to see this, especially for all of you who interlock the golf club. Very precious information coming your way right now. Stay tuned. But before we start, because this is valuable stuff that you never want to miss, so please subscribe to the channel for your sake.
Please leave a comment or question down below and give us a thumbs up.
And be sure to hit that bell so you don't miss any videos. So
right. Now, get yourself your old-fashioned yardstick at a yard sale, if you will. And you'll notice the way we take the grip is, imagine I'm holding an umbrella. So notice how the yardstick fits right underneath the heel pad of my hand. So you get a beautiful squeeze right there of that yardstick underneath. And now, yeah, there's a little wear spot right there, but this glove is over a month old and I use it every day. So most of you can't last a day without tearing a hole in it. That's why you want to have the heel pad on top of the yardstick like this. See how that works? So there's a great way, notice how my fingers are wrapping around the yardstick and coming right back into the palm like that. Notice how my thumb's on top. So this feels very compressive. Now, notice my thumb is coming in from a 1 o'clock position back to noon to the top of that yardstick. Why is that so important? Because at the top of the backswing, my golf club is going to be settling on top of the tip of that thumb, of your lead thumb. All right, now here's the important stuff. When you take your trail hand and you put it on, notice how my hand is, the two pads of my trail hand will fit in the thumb, and my fingers are gonna wrap around the yardstick right here. So my fingerprints are gonna go right there. Now notice how that index hooks onto that. See there? It's right up against the yardstick. So if I put a little bit of pressure, I could snap that thing very easily right now. Notice how I'm applying pressure with that index finger. And then the thumb just comes alongside the other side of the yardstick. So at the top of the backswing, what actually supports the yardstick is my index finger. Now, if I take that and I interlock all the way in, watch what happens. See what happens now? Everything just disintegrates. This is what I see all too often. Notice how the middle finger and the ring finger are wrapping around the thumb of my trail hand, right? And then there's no place to put the index and the thumb. So in desperation, you got to put the thumb on top to stabilize the top of that hand. So then you get a lot of blisters on the hand. You get a lot of blisters in the palm of your right hand. You got to wear two gloves. And it's altogether a pretty bad thing because when you don't interlock properly, so notice if I put this down here, Sav, can you take a look at the, just make sure everything's in the frame? So if I've got my 10-finger grip, you see everything nicely? So notice how all my fingers are nicely wrapped around the club. My index finger hooks on my thumb alongside, just like I showed you in the yardstick. Now, if I overlap, notice all I did was bring my pinky over between my middle finger and my index on my lead hand. And now, if I interlock, notice how I can only interlock halfway so that everything stays intact. Notice how my fingers are neatly wrapped around the grip and my index finger stays right up against the side of the shaft and the thumb comes alongside. Look how tidy that is, right? So if I take my left hand off and I put some pressure against the ground, notice the pressure, these fingers are leveraging against that index finger and everything stays very tidy. Where you go wrong is the interlock, which should only be about half, you go all the way in. So watch what happens. You go all the way in. And look at what happens here. Complete disintegration of that right hand. Notice where I got the club running right now through my right hand. That will annihilate your golf swing. So I can't throw from here. It's like taking a ball. Notice when I throw a ball, I'm holding it in my fingers. See this grip right here? That is identical to the grip you should have with the golf club. Look how tidy that is. Index hooks on, thumb alongside. Notice when I hinge at the top of the backswing, how the club is resting underneath the index finger. But if I interlock all the way in, watch what happens. Now it's just resting here. And if I don't have the size of a baseball bat, I can't stabilize that. It's just going to move around in my hands and create a lot of havoc. So that index finger, the way it hooks on and the thumb comes alongside, look how vacuum sealed that is and how the thumb and the grip of my lead hand fit right between the two pads of my trail hand. Now everything can hinge up and down beautifully on my snuff boxes. The anatomical snuff boxes are that little cavity above your thumbs, and I get this beautiful simultaneous hinge of both hands. Now if I go all the way in again, well, look at how one hand is on one side of the club and the other hand is on the other side of the club. I see this way too often. So I have competing hands now. So if I hinge on the right side, the left side collapses and it'll feel very, very tender actually. And if I hinge on the left side, then everything cups and my club face ends up being open off the face of the planet. So you're going to be playing army golf, right, left, right, left. All right, we'd be going always to the side. Whereas when your hands are nicely hinging properly, they hinge in the backswing, release and rehinge in the finish. So I'm going to bring Moo in here and I'm going to show you Moo's favorite drill for club head speed. And you will see how important it is to have both hands tidy on the club so that that beautiful release can occur in your swing. And we did a video a while back that says 5 more miles per hour with this drill. And here it comes. Moo?
Hey, Sean.
All right. Your dominant hand is your left hand.
Correct.
So we'll start with that.
Okay.
So let's say you had a bamboo shoot here and you're going to slash it towards Sav.
Okay.
So give it a nice slash. Beautiful. Now, as Moo is doing that, keep going.
Okay.
You'll notice how he's never letting go of the club, and there's a release into the backswing, and there's a full release into the finish. Hold your finish. So notice in the finish, you've got this beautiful reload on that snuff box here, and that's what allows him to go back in the other direction. Release and hold. So at the top of the backswing, notice it's nicely hinged on that snuff box and it's ready to slash in the opposite direction.
Right, yeah.
Now do it with the lead hand. So we're gathering in the backswing, release and release and rehinge. And Moo at this stop right there. Now so many of you over here are going to be letting go of the club. So notice Moo is not letting go of that club, right Moo?
No.
And that's what allows the club to fully release his lead arm into that finish. Okay?
Yeah.
So let's look at I haven't shown you this yet.
No.
So go ahead and hold that with your right hand first.
Okay.
So notice how the heel pad fits on top.
Yep.
Close your hand around it.
Okay.
Feel that?
Yeah.
So you could literally crush that in your hand and make a big dent.
Yeah.
Feel how there's so much leverage in there, right?
Yeah.
Feels really good.
Yeah.
So face this way with it.
Okay.
Beautiful. Yeah. And look at that. I mean, the heel pads are on top, and he's got some beautiful leverage there.
Yeah.
All right, come on back. Now put the other hand on.
Okay.
Above that. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, above it. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
Very good. Okay. So notice the trail hand fits right on the thumb of the lead hand. You feel that?
Yeah.
And notice Moo's fingers are wrapped around the wood part, but they're not wrapping around the thumb and the top of the thumb there.
Yeah, that's right.
So notice if I were to put a little pressure against my hand.
Okay.
There, feel that?
Yeah.
You can stretch out that index a bit more. Right here?
Okay.
There, feel that? Now push against it. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's how you apply pressure through the ball. Now notice that hand is pushing this way.
Yeah, it's going this way. And,
that hand's pushing that way, and then you get this beautiful release that's going to occur through the shot. Can you feel that?
Yeah.
So there's, I mean, I could see how that's going to help you a ton, you know, as far as feeling the leverage and how the lead hand clamps on the grip.
Yeah, it helps a lot.
Feels pretty good, doesn't it?
It does, yeah.
All right. Thanks, Moo.
No problem.
Excellent. Sav, come on over. Sav has an interlocking grip.
Yep.
And a very strong interlocking grip. Moo, do you want to man the camera just to make sure we get this in the frame? Because a lot of people are going to benefit from this.
Okay.
So let me see you put the lead hand on. Just that. Okay. So do you feel there? Feel that? So doesn't that feel like you could crush that ruler in there?
Mm-hmm.
So face the camera that way. So can you see that move?
Yeah.
So right now, does it feel like you could just dent your hand with the side of that ruler?
Yeah.
Okay. Now put the other hand on. Good. Come face the camera the other way. Face me. There we go. So notice how the two pads of her trail hand fit right in the thumb. The index finger wraps around that, push against my body. Good. And then the thumb just comes alongside there. So a little more in the fingers.
No, that's the wrong way. It's my...
Yeah, yeah. Just a little more in the fingers. There. Feel that?
Yeah.
So push against my body. Do you feel how that hand's going that way?
Yeah.
Now, in your case, face the camera now. This would be a very neutral grip for you.
Yeah.
But you play like this, don't you?
Yeah.
Notice we haven't changed anything in the hands. You still have the same grip club relationship. Your hands are just like that. Now, doesn't it feel like you're going to slice through that bamboo shoot this way?
Yeah.
All right, let's see it. Give it a good slash. So do it in slow-mo. Yes, very good. Again, slow motion. Stop just before impact. So notice that trail arm is still bent. The hands are coming through first. And then as this trail arm extends, it starts to square up. We're collecting the ball from here and we're releasing the ball in that direction there. Did you hear where the wind occurred?
Mm-hmm.
Do it again. You hear it?
Yeah.
So make a swing now. Awesome. One more time. That was really good, Sav. Wow. So the yardstick actually has a wonderful sound that it's going to make, and you always want to hear that sound in the direction of the target. That's where you want to spend the energy in your swing.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll see in the video, you see Sav swinging now, and you really see as she's coming in slow motion how her hands come through first, then the shaft, then the heel of the club, and she collects the ball here. And the full extension of her arms is out here.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where you get that amazing speed. Now, if we were, get your club, I wanna have you experience what a lot of students are experiencing right now. Go ahead and take your grip. Okay, so Mo, you got that?
Yeah.
So notice how that Lead hand's on top, the trail hand is underneath. Mm-hmm. See how her fingers are neatly wrapped around the grip. Now, what I want you to do is interlock all the way in. All the way. Uh-oh. Right? Doesn't that feel absolutely horrible?
Yeah, now my grip is neutral.
We really feel for you because it'll feel strange at first when you get this grip going, but the benefits to your golf swing are going to be 100-fold. It's going to be amazing for you because now go ahead and take that grip again. I know it doesn't feel very good,
well,
right?
Neutral grip now.
Well, it's neutral here, but it's strong here. You actually have a neutral top hand and a very strong bottom hand. Now take your backswing. How are you supposed to hinge your wrists?
It actually hurts.
It does hurt, yeah. Exactly. So this becomes very strained.
Yeah.
Okay? And the support at the top of the swing has been compromised. Mm. So, all right? Very important that you get this settled. Another video I want you to look at is called Knife the Grip, Sean Clement. It's a real oldie, but a real goodie. You need to get your bottom hand intact and make sure that you don't interlock all the way in. It's a partial interlock. It's not a full bore all the way in interlock. Okay? Thanks for your help, Sav.
Welcome.
Moo, thanks, buddy.